The shock of a breast cancer diagnosis is often followed by questions about how and by whom you will be treated. Your cancer treatment team will vary depending on the community in which you live and your particular cancer diagnosis. You may be treated in a facility such as a hospital cancer institute, or you may go to a combination of different specialists' offices, diagnostic and surgical centers, and hospitals for treatment. Regardless of the location, a team of doctors will coordinate care and tailor it to you as an individual, and they may meet regularly to discuss your treatment and progress. Fortunately, the majority of breast cancers are detected at early stages when there are more treatment options available. This animation introduces the roles of cancer treatment team members to empower you with knowledge of what to expect before treatment begins. People instrumental in making the initial breast cancer diagnosis include the primary care physician, radiologist, and pathologist. Often the discovery of breast cancer starts with a visit to a primary care physician or obstetrician-gynecologist, OB-GYN. You may report finding a lump, or your physician may find an abnormality during a routine clinical breast exam. In these cases, the physician will recommend a mammogram. A diagnostic mammogram or additional imaging may also be suggested if there is a suspicious finding during a routine screening mammogram. Your mammogram and any other imaging tests will generally be performed by a technologist, and the results will be reviewed by a radiologist who specializes in interpreting breast imagery. If cancer is suspected, more imaging and other tests may be requested to help with a diagnosis. In some cases, a specialist known as a breast interventional radiologist may take a small sample of breast tissue called a biopsy so that it may be further studied to determine or rule out cancer. In other instances, you may be referred to a surgeon for a biopsy. After a biopsy is performed, the sample will be sent to a pathologist, who is a specialist in diagnosing and classifying disease. The pathologist will examine the tissue sample under a microscope to determine whether or not the sample is cancerous, and will report the findings to your primary physician or surgeon. You may wonder why breast cancer treatment usually involves a team of specialists. The uncontrolled cell growth that becomes breast cancer results from changes in your genetic material, DNA. Therefore, each breast cancer is as genetically unique as the individuals in which they occur. Cancer cells start from a single defective cell, but they change as they divide, and the millions of cells that make up a tumor can become different from each other. To target these differences and ensure optimal results, breast cancer treatment may involve surgery, radiation therapy, and medications that prevent cancer cells from growing. In most cases, a surgeon, a medical oncologist, and a radiation oncologist will form the core of your treatment team. You may also have the aid of a nurse navigator, oncology nurse, social worker, physical therapist, or rehabilitation specialist for help with coordination, support, and rehabilitation. A reconstructive or plastic surgeon may also join the team. Your first step after diagnosis will be to meet with your physician or surgeon to discuss your history, diagnosis, and treatment options. This person may be your primary contact, or they may direct you to someone such as a nurse navigator or coordinator who will assist with treatment planning and can direct any questions about diagnosis, treatment, or follow-up to the appropriate specialist. Ask your physician or surgeon if you are unsure if there is someone available to help coordinate care. Nurse or patient navigators and oncology nurse specialists are professionals that help people coordinate cancer care. They help with scheduling tests and consultations and can help get answers to questions. The coordinator can also provide referrals for emotional support, educational resources, financial support, transportation, and childcare during your treatment. The navigator coordinator will ensure your information is up to date and shared among the team members, and may attend tumor boards, during which specialists meet to review your treatment and progress. The nurse navigator or oncology nurse can also help with survivorship and connect patients and their families to community care resources. Your surgeon will review your diagnosis and history and will help you decide how to best treat the breast cancer surgically. Surgery may take the form of breast-conserving surgical procedures or mastectomy procedures in which the breast is removed. For mastectomies, the surgeon will also refer you to a plastic surgeon to discuss reconstruction possibilities. After surgery, your surgeon will assess healing and determine whether additional surgery is needed to get clean, cancer-free margins around the treatment site. At the conclusion of the surgery, the surgeon will refer you to a medical oncologist or radiation oncologist for additional treatment. Medical oncologists are doctors who specialize in treating cancer with medications. These medications include chemotherapy, which works on the entire body to kill cancer cells or prevent them from growing, hormonal therapy medications, which specifically target cancer cells and starve them of hormones they need to grow, or biologic therapy medications, which also target specific cancer cells and disable processes needed for their growth and survival. After discussing your history and treatment options, an individualized treatment regimen for your particular type and stage of cancer will be created. In some cases, cancer medications may be given prior to surgery to help shrink the size of a tumor, which is called neoadjuvant or before surgery therapy. More commonly, chemotherapy is given after surgery, in which case it is called adjuvant chemotherapy. Radiation oncologists specialize in using doses of high-energy radiation to target and treat cancer. Radiation therapy is common after breast-conserving surgical procedures, where it is used to destroy residual tumor cells in the breast tissue. When you meet, your radiation oncologist will go over your diagnosis and treatment options and will determine the most effective form of radiation therapy for your cancer. Treatment may vary according to your age, lymph node status, and tumor characteristics. The radiation oncologist will plan and direct treatments, which are administered by a radiation therapy technologist. Plastic or reconstructive surgeons are doctors who specialize in performing appearance-altering surgeries. After a mastectomy, the breast mound can be reconstructed, a nipple can be recreated, and the dark-colored areolar region around the nipple can be repigmented. Insurance will cover reconstruction as well as surgery on the opposite breast to restore symmetry if necessary. You can talk to both your general and plastic surgeons about your preferences and options for breast reconstruction, either at the same time as surgery or after completion of your treatments. Depending on the structure of the medical community where you live, your treatment team may meet periodically at a tumor board. At these meetings, doctors from different specialties review patients' specific treatments and progress. Regardless of the structure of your treatment team, your specialists will tailor treatment for your specific cancer, health condition, and personal decisions. Their goal will be to ensure you receive the best possible treatment to optimize your chances for long-term health.